Hey, it's Joey for Digital DJ Tips, and right now I'm going to give you a short tutorial on how to rip your records, cassettes, and other analog sources over onto your laptop running Rekordbox. Now, Rekordbox is Pioneer DJ's music management software. It's free to download and free to use. You don't need to buy any specific Pioneer DJ gear in order to use it. It works kind of like iTunes on your computer. Now, why would you want to rip your record collection? Well, let's say you've got a lot of vinyl that you want to spin whenever you play a gig and you don't want to take along a crate of records and you don't want to take along a turntable. Well, that's when ripping the records over onto your laptop becomes handy, because if you use Rekordbox for that, that means that you can export it to a thumb drive for use at the club CDJ system. Or you can even just hook up your DJ controller to your laptop, and since you've already ripped the vinyl over onto your hard drive, you can spin with it next time you play at a gig. Now, another good reason to digitize your vinyl is, let's say you are a scratch DJ and you've got a collection of vinyl, like this one from Stone's Throw, and basically they're pretty much worn out, you've scratched them through the years, and you want to preserve them as much as possible. So by ripping that record over onto Rekordbox, that means that you can just use a DVS, whether you've got a turntable connected or a pair of CDJs, and you can scratch with the MP3 file instead of abusing or further abusing the original record that you've got. So you can just keep this in storage for, you know, posterity or later use. Before we get to the how-to, let me talk about the whys. Why would you want to use Rekordbox for DJing? Well, first and foremost, Rekordbox is meant to manage the music that you use for DJing. So unlike iTunes, you're not going to find books or movies or TV shows or Apple Music streaming in here. This is just meant to be the stuff that you DJ with. So you can be sure that whenever you find an MP3 here, or a WAV file, or even a short video clip, it means that you're gonna be using that for your gigs. And of course, with Rekordbox, you can export those media over onto a USB thumb drive for use at the club CDJ system. Further, if you DJ with a controller, or you want to DJ with your laptop while at the club, you can purchase the performance pack add-on over at the Rekordbox store. It's called Rekordbox DJ, and that means that you can connect your laptop to the CDJs or use it with a DJ controller, a la Serato DJ, Traktor, Virtual DJ, and so on. And finally, Rekordbox just lets you rip all of your old media, whether those are vinyl, cassettes, CDs, mini discs, 8-tracks, 4-tracks, 2-inch tape, whatever. As long as you have the interface and the connections in order to get that music over onto your laptop, you're good to go. Okay, now let's get on over to the how-tos. There are three ways that you can get a vinyl record over onto Rekordbox. Start with the first one, which is the easiest, and this is by using a turntable with a USB output. There are some consumer turntables as well as professional or DJ turntables that have USB outputs. So all you gotta do is to connect that USB out over onto your laptop. This Epsilon Pro turntable has such an output, so all I have to do is to connect the USB cable over here and plug it into my laptop running Rekordbox, and then I'm good to go. Now, the second way is to use a DJ controller, DJ mixer, or audio interface or scratch box that is DVS ready. And it has to be DVS ready because that means that the controller, mixer, or audio interface has a phono input that actually sends the audio over onto your laptop. And that's how Rekordbox will be able to record the audio coming in. Right now, I'm using the Pioneer DJ DDJ RZ controller, which is also DVS ready, and it also has phono inputs. So that means that all I gotta do, let's say this is my turntable and I don't have the USB connection over here, I can just plug the RCA jacks from the phono outputs over to the phono inputs on one of the channels of my DDJ RZ, and then the audio will then go into Rekordbox long as I have my DJ controller connected to it. So that's method number two. Now the third and final way is to use a USB phono or line audio interface. Something like the ART USB Phono Plus would work in this scenario. It's basically a little box which has a USB output that you hook up to your laptop, and it has a pair of phono or line inputs. That's where you connect the outputs of your turntable to, whether that's a Technics 1200 or a consumer turntable or other turntable that you may have. So in this video, we're gonna do two things. First off, I'm gonna show you how to download and install Rekordbox on your laptop. And then after that, we're gonna hook up my turntable, my controller over onto my laptop. And then I'm gonna show you how to get this piece of vinyl over onto Rekordbox. Let's get started. Right, let's get Rekordbox downloaded and installed on your computer. So head on over to the Rekordbox website, as I've done, and left click on free download over here, and then just click on the big red button over here in the middle that says free to download. I'm on a Mac, so that's why it says Mac version 4.3.0. If you're in a PC, it should say PC or Windows version 4.3.0. So just left click on that to download it. Agree to the user agreement and hit download. Now just wait for the download to finish. Cool, so when it's finished downloading, just head on over to your downloads folder and double click on the zip file called install Rekordbox 4.3.0. And it'll instruct the installer, so just double click on that as well, which will launch the setup process, and you can just follow the prompts to install Rekordbox on your computer. So when it's finished installing, head on over to your applications folder or your desktop if you're in a PC, and then scroll through until you find the Rekordbox 4 folder. Double click on it and double click on the Rekordbox icon to launch the software for the first time. Right, so now that we've installed Rekordbox on your laptop, it's time to get ripping. Let's start with method number one, which is using a USB turntable hooked up to your laptop. I'm using the Epsilon Pro DJT1300 USB, which has a USB output. You can use any USB turntable that you want. But basically, all we need to do is to connect a USB cable. So I've got the other end of this lead hooked up to the USB output of this deck. And then I just need to connect this now to a free port over here in my laptop. There we go. And if you wait a while, the record portion of the Rekordbox interface will pop up. So if I bring my mouse over here, you're going to find over here in the drop-down it says USB Rec, meaning that it is taking as an input the USB turntable, which is good. And then you've got the level knob over here, which is set to 12 o'clock. Also good. Don't need to mess around with this. And you've got the record button over here. Now, before we start recording, I want to make sure that we have our record queued up, just like how you would normally queue a record when you're DJing. So I'm going to hit start on my turntable, and I'm going to put my needle over here. Let's say I want to record the first track of this piece of vinyl. Okay, so this is the first beat, and I want to start the recording over here. So I'm going to move it back just a little bit. There we go. Hit stop. Now I'm going to hit record on Rekordbox so it'll start recording. There we go. And I'm going to hit play on my turntable. Cool, so Rekordbox is now recording the audio coming from the turntable and into your laptop. Okay, so let's say that the recording has finished, or this track has finished. I'm going to hit stop over here in Rekordbox. I'm going to hit stop on my turntable. And now Rekordbox will ask me for the artist's name. There we go, so hit OK for that. Now, your recording will show up over here in the recordings tree of Rekordbox. Tracks over here. So you can just left click and drag this on up. And
And now you can just play it like any normal MP3 file. You can add cue points if you want to. Add loop in and out points, and so on. So that's it. It's super, super easy. That's the first method of doing it. Now let's have a look at the second way that you can get a piece of vinyl recorded onto your laptop using a DJ controller. So I am going to unplug the USB turntable first. Let's do it like this. Now I've got this turntable hooked up to my DJ RZ, and it's connected via a pair of RCA cables through channel number 3, which is using the phono input. Now I am going to connect this onto my laptop using a USB cable, like so. There we go. Now when the record portion pops up, you're going to notice here in the drop down it says master out. That basically means that any of the outputs that is coming out of the DDJ RZ will be recorded within Rekordbox. And that's good because the output from the controller will essentially be this record over here. So let's say I want to record another piece of vinyl over here. Let's see, I want to record this Bob Dylan record that my aunt gave me like 15 years ago. Bob Dylan was her favorite, so it's a nice little keepsake that I have. Place this here. And I've got my controller hooked up and ready. Now all I need to do, again, is to just cue up the record. Let's say I want to record the first track here. Okay, so let's say I've queued it up. This is the beginning of the track. Just make sure that my levels are proper over here in my controller. And then again, I just hit the record button here. And then I hit play on the turntable, and Rekordbox automatically records the track.
Right, so that's it for this quick tutorial. Rekordbox basically has become a one-stop shop. You can use it to manage a music library, you can use it to export music to a thumb drive, or even to perform with it. And finally, you can use it to rip music that you may have on analog formats. I've got a full training article over at the Digital DJ Tips website. The link is in the description box below. Please hit that thumbs up icon if you like this video and you found it helpful, and hit that subscribe button if you are not a subscriber yet. My name is Joey. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see you next time.